In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the 3D LUTs from our NOLA collection into Lightroom so you can use them in the RAW processing here and or in Adobe Photoshop Camera RAW. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first step, once you have Lightroom open, you're gonna go into Develop for option one. And then right here where it says Adobe Profile, you're going to click on Browse. That is going to open up our profile browser. And we're gonna go ahead and click this plus button, this drop down, and click Import Profiles. So I have them in my Downloads folder, so you're gonna open that and go ahead and Command A on a Mac, or highlight all of them, and then hit Import. Okay, so the way that these are set up, you'll see that they just imported over here, and you don't need to label them. I've already pre-labeled them so they have your natural light NOLA, and you'll see that it says 208. And from right here, you can just very quickly scroll through and see that Cine Zero is the name of this specific LUT, and this all has the exact same color grade. And then you'll see here that the SR, so that's Shadow Recovery 100, Shadow Recovery 50, so that's basically an extra 50%, a 25% increase. So you'll see here that this photo itself has a little bit of a loss of detail or getting very close to it in the highlights. So if you were to look at something where the highlight recovery is starting at 25%, maybe closer to 50%, you can kind of start to see that it will change the histogram here. And you'll also see that it's not actually changing any of the develop sliders here. So under develop, under profile, you'll see that I'm using the Cine Zero shadow recovery, highlight recovery 50. And the way that this is set up is Cine Zero is essentially a very neutral color grade. It's more of just a tonal, you know, not a huge shift in color. And you'll start to see with Cine 1 all the way down to Cine 15. That the colors and the color grades themselves shift quite a bit using the 3D LUT. So the way that these work too is they've already been installed, so you don't need to reinstall them into Adobe Camera Raw. So if you were to open this in Photoshop as a smart object, okay, so even if you make changes in Lightroom and then want to go into Photoshop, as long as you have this set as your base layer, if you double click that smart object, you can see here that these are already installed in the exact same way. So if you wanted to, let's say, you know, increase your highlight recovery even more, you could do that here. And then the sliders themselves are set up to kind of fine tune this one, right? So you can even fine tune in between 50 and 75. You can, you know, find 60-ish somewhere right in there. So you'll see here that once you install them into Lightroom, they're also installed into Camera Raw. Camera Raw and Lightroom are using the same raw processor. So a lot of the moves and a lot of the things that happen with raw processing, it's the same thing. It's just a different interface. So it doesn't matter which one you're using. You're going to get the same effect using either one with these LUTs.